Excel sees dates and times differently from a human. Everything about Excel's date system is based on the 1st of January 1900. That is, how many days are we from the 1st of January 1900? Apple Macs happen to use the 1st of January 1904. So let's just understand how this works. If I type in a date like the 1st of January 1900, what you see here is Excel just formatting it nicely to you, for you. If you change the format and went to a number, for example, you'll see it's got a 1 there. Why 1? Because what it's telling us is you've entered the 1st of January 1900. I'm basing everything on the 1st of January 1900. So that is 1 day away. Notice that if I enter the 1st of January 1890, it's not a valid date. Dates do not exist prior to then. 2nd of January 1900 would be date 2. Later in that year, it's day 366. That happened to be a leap year. A year later, 731. The year 2000 is 36,526 days from the 1st of January 1900. And if you put in a crazy date, like the 1st of January 1999, you'll see it generates a number of 2.9 million. And you'll see a date like the 16th of November is 42,690. So everything that we see as a date, which we think looks like that, Excel actually sees as a number. With that knowledge now, it should be easy to see how you can work with dates. So for example, if I want to take these dates, and I want to add 7 days to it. All I do is I create a formula, and all that formula is saying is take a date, and even though we see it as a date, Excel sees it as a number, and add 7 to it. So if we format it, we see 8th of January 1900, but notice that this is basically what Excel sees. 1 plus 7 is 8. If it's not a valid date, it doesn't matter. If you're on day 2 and you add 7 days, you get to day 9. Day 9 is the 9th of January 1900. So as long as you're aware that dates are actually numbers and you can treat them just like a number, you can add and subtract to them and they will automatically do the correct thing. So given that this is simply a number, it should be relatively easy to work with. The real problem with dates though, if I scroll down here, is that different people see dates formatted in different ways. So for example, that is a date that to me looks like a date, but so is that one there, 18th of November 1998. And yet, if I try and format them as numbers to see if Excel's seeing them as a date, can you see that one changes, this one didn't. And that's because as far as Excel is concerned, that is not a date. So it's very important when you have dates and they're formatted in any of these ways, you can see there's day, month, year, month, day, year, typed in the name, etc. Sometimes Excel sees it as a date and it can therefore convert it to a number. Sometimes it doesn't. So it's extremely, extremely important that just because it looks like a date to you as the human, you need to check, is Excel seeing it as a date? Because a lot of the things we're going to teach you subsequent to this will not work if Excel doesn't recognize it as a date and doesn't have this number.